A four-state art exhibit is the first of its kind. We'll tell you why, plus...
Women and men both need to be very cognizant that they can and are susceptible.
Local doctors say men need to be aware of breast cancer also. The banking industry might be investigated. How violations of antitrust laws could be in play.
Live from KODE 12, you're watching Action 12 News, the weekend edition.
Good evening, I'm Morgan Shutters. Thanks for joining us. Members of Congress are asking the Justice Department to investigate if some banks might be violating antitrust laws. They have even called upon the Attorney General to do a full investigation to get to the bottom of major banks, charging fees for your debit card and your checking account. So far, three of the largest banks in the U.S. have announced the fees: Bank of America, J.P. Morgan Chase, and Wells Fargo. The closure of several state offices leaves the Missouri Department of Transportation with millions of now unused dollars. MoDOT officials have eliminated 667 staff positions and closed 23 facilities, also selling hundreds of pieces of equipment. This means nearly $200 million of funding is now available for new construction. Authorities say that money will be spent on critical road and bridge projects throughout the state. Estimates show by 2015, the cuts will have saved MoDOT more than $500 million. Well, it was another beautiful day, cooling off as the night goes on. Turning now to Fort State weather, Dan Greer joins us in the Weather Center. What does it look like for the week, Dan?
Looks pretty scary. It's looking a little bit like Halloween early. Don't stay. Actually, it's not that bad. Down 2 degrees in the last hour, so it's going to get a little chilly toward daybreak. But in the meantime, temperatures mild, and we do have clouds on the way. Chance for some rain as we head into the next 36 hours. Today, very nice, so sunny and 87 in Joplin. It's 88 in Grove, a little cooler to the north, but still everybody in the 80s today. Fort Scott, 82 degrees here on a Sunday in October. Clear skies and 62 now in Joplin. Humidity at 48%. Winds from the north northeast at 9 miles an hour. At midnight, 59. Clear skies. A few clouds at daybreak, 50. So a little on the chilly side. By afternoon, though, we've got plenty of clouds. Temperatures in the mid-70s, so it'll be quite a bit cooler than what we saw today. And I'll have all the details in just a few minutes.
Still comfortable, though.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dan. A new report shows fewer Oklahomans are lighting up their cigarettes than ever before. State surveys show 100,000 fewer smokers than the year before. That's a historic low. However, Oklahoma health officials say the state is still above the national adult smoking average. Nearly 6,000 Oklahomans die each year as a result of smoking, and the leading preventable cause of death. State officials are warning residents this month to keep young Kansans safe and aware of SIDS. Sudden infant death syndrome is the unexpected death of an otherwise healthy baby. In 2009, 13.4% of infant deaths in Kansas are attributed to SIDS, making it the third highest cause of death for infants in Kansas. SIDS is most common for children 2 to 4 months old. Most babies killed by SIDS were found in unsafe sleeping conditions, not on their backs, or in a home where smoking is allowed. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and local experts are asking women and men to get checked. Numbers show for several years, fewer women have died from breast cancer nationwide. Cases have also become less severe. Some say educating folks about breast cancer has reduced those numbers. However, local health officials say not just women need to get checked, men do too. Doctors say to perform self-breast examinations at least once a month and schedule one mammogram per year. Local doctors say the breast cancer awareness campaign is already bringing in more women to get screened for the disease. Authorities at the Freeman Women's Pavilion have given more than 10 mammograms already this month. And more than 260 people today walked around the track at Carl Junction High School for the cause. 19 sponsored teams put on their tennis shoes for breast cancer awareness, raising more than $1,000. That's an increase from last year. More than 300 people attended. Many of the walkers are currently fighting breast cancer themselves.
October's been huge for us. I was actually in the Springfield walk yesterday, and I raised almost $600 within like a half hour. People are willing to give.
T-shirts are still available for $10, with all proceeds going to breast cancer research. Contact information is on our website. An emotional art exhibit pays tribute to the women who are fighting for their lives. The city of Joplin today proclaimed Breast Wishes at the Spiva Center for the Arts as the very first art exhibit in the area to deal with the subject of breast cancer. Many of the artists featured in the gallery have a personal tie to the disease.
I wanted to try to give something back to the community, try to give back to our artists, give them some exposure of how they truly have supported our breast cancer efforts in the four state area.
Donations from the exhibit go to the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. The organization is on target to provide $100,000 to help those dealing with the disease this year in the four states. Two volunteer artists from the nonprofit Splashes of Hope. That's in New York. They're visiting Joplin. The artists are painting murals inside the Ronald McDonald House of the Four States. They hope the art will give joy to families of seriously ill children who stay there. With so many trees destroyed in the tornado, the murals are titled Landscapes of Joplin and incorporate greenery in every piece.
We just feel very honored out of 309 Ronald McDonald houses to be one of nine that was selected to receive these wonderful pieces of art.
The artists are headed next to Springfield, Illinois. All Kansas state flags are ordered to be lowered today in honor of fallen firefighters. Flags throughout the state will fly at half-mast. This is in recognition of the 30th annual National Fallen Firefighter Memorial Service. At a national service, 72 firefighters were honored who lost their lives in 2010. Of those, six were killed in Kansas fires. Since 1981, more than 3,500 men and women have been honored at the National Fallen Firefighters Memorial. The Grand River Dam Authority chooses a new chief executive to run the utility. State Representative Dan Sullivan was offered the position as CEO and Director of Investments this week. Sullivan, a Tulsa native, is the Republican majority floor leader. He will replace former GRDA CEO Kevin Easley, who resigned in August. Sullivan officially starts his new position December 1st. Many phone charges on your bill might be unauthorized. Coming up, insight about mystery fees called cramming. Stay with us.
You're watching Action 12 News, the weekend edition with Morgan Shutters. Weather with meteorologist Dan Greer and sports with Nick Keene.